Oh, joy of joys, I am repairing my laptop again. I say repair. What it actually involves is me removing this SSD, this mini SSD, after I remove the battery, of course. And then when I remove that, I pop the battery back in, start it, so it starts working again, and it works and starts up properly. Then I have to turn it off, remove the battery, then pop that back in, screw it back in place, and it works fine because I use that for storage. So I use that for storage up there, and these are my ones with the operating system. They're the ones with the shared like BIOS or whatever it's called. So basically, every couple of months, I have to basically remove that and pop it back in effect. There's more steps than that, but it's still basically that. And the main problem is because it started out when I took my laptop and had a problem with the battery and problem with power to the laptop shop, and they found a whole bunch of problems, and they're trying to convince me it'd be more hassle than it's worth. This is going back around about 4.5, 5 years ago, and they were offering me only like 350 quid. Oh yeah, we could pay you 350 quid for it, but that's all we can give you. It's like, really? You know? And 5 years later, it still works. I can still play games like Fallout 4, Skyrim, Elder Scrolls Online, etc. I can play games like that, no problem. I can play games like GTA 5 and GTA 5 Online, which is the same game pretty much, but it's like different sides of the same game, and no problemo. Some overheating, yeah. I can just turn on the fan. There's a little button on the other side I can press, and it basically allows me to turn on the fan whenever I want. And yeah, it's a pretty decent gaming laptop, and yeah, I mean, it's not the best. It's not able to, withstand the highest quality in terms of gaming experience. But even so, I get a lot of value for money out of it, and it makes a lot more sense for me to use this and get all of this, life out of it, basically, rather than simply taking 300 or 350 quid from the laptop shop. Instead, I spent a bit of money on getting that SSD. I got that one out of an old laptop I had. I've changed the battery once because I had a problem with that around about 2 years ago. But apart from that, everything is honky dory, more or less. Apart from when I have to do this, but apart from that, it's probably going to last me for a couple of more years at least. And even if it doesn't, I've managed to get more than 300 quid's worth out of it. I originally purchased it for about 600 quid. It was nearly new. It'd been used for 6 months. Someone thought, oh, it's not as good as I would have hoped. And it's like, well, it'll do me as a basic. So I purchased it on that kind of premise. And it replaced my old Republic of Gaming laptop. This is an MSI laptop, but I won't go into too many details, it's not important. But my old Republic of Gaming laptop was a 2012 model I was using in 2014, 2015. So when I replaced it with this in 2015, I think it was, basically it allowed me to step up a little bit, not end up with my computer overheating massively as my old laptop did. So, yeah, I try and get my money's worth out of things when I can. Not always possible, but I tend to buy used, and it makes it a lot easier for me to get what I want out of what I get, even if sometimes it's a bit of a pain.